In this video, I'm going to talk about the elbow extension test to rule out fractures of the elbow.
Get our very own assessment ebook and mobile app. Links are in the video description.
Hi and welcome back to Physiotutors. In their multi-center validation study, Appelbaum et al. In the year 2008 evaluated the elbow extension test and found a sensitivity of 96.8% and a low specificity of 48.5% for the detection of elbow fractures in children from the age of 3 and adults combined. For this reason, this test has a high clinical value to rule out elbow fractures in practice. To perform the test, have the patient seated with exposed and supinated arms, then ask him to flex his shoulders to 90 degrees and then fully extend and lock both elbows. Injured and uninjured sides are compared visually and those with equal extension recorded as full extension. Patients who cannot fully extend their elbow after injury should be referred for radiography, as they have a nearly 50% chance of fracture. For those who are fully able to extend their elbow, radiography can be deferred if the practitioner is confident that an olecranon fracture is not present. Patients who do not undergo radiography should return if symptoms have not resolved within 7 to 10 days. Alright, this was our video on the elbow extension test. If you are curious about how to exclude fractures of the wrist, watch our video on the Karadeniz wrist rules by a click right next to me. Thanks a lot for watching. Don't forget to hit the like button and to subscribe to our channel if you haven't yet. You can find more of us in the links in the description of this video down below. This was Kai for Physiotutors. See you next time. Bye.